Hello viewer, welcome to from 2 Physics lesson 5. The topic is measurement 2 and we are discussing a measurement of length using vernier calipers and micrometer screw gauge. So this is Elim TV and I hope you're going to enjoy the lesson. I'm your teacher Benjamin K. Makanda. Enjoy the lesson. So before we begin our lesson, we want to look at the specific objectives of this lesson. And these are some of our specific objectives that we want to achieve by the end of the lesson. So by the end of this lesson, the learner should be able to measure the length using vernier calipers, and this is the main objective of the lesson. So once we are done with the lesson, you as a learner should be able to measure length using the vernier calipers. A vernier caliper is just one of the instruments or apparatus that we use to measure length, as we are going to discuss in our lesson. Now, the lesson preview. So the lesson is in this order. First of all, let's have a brief review of lesson 4. And in lesson 4, we discussed about the need for measurement. Why do we have to do the measurements? That was our lesson number 4. And just to connect lesson 4 to what we discussed in form 1 about measurement 1, you realize that some of the objects that we have to take their measurements, we may not use the ordinary apparatus or instruments that are available. So in this lesson, we are going to look at other instruments or apparatus that can be used to measure those dimensions or quantities that can otherwise not be measured in the methods that we discussed in form one. Now, so the second thing that we have to discuss here, we're going to look at the measure of length using vernier calipers. That's the main activity that we have to do here. How do we measure length using a vernier caliper? So you have to understand what vernier calipers are and how they can be used to measure lengths of objects. Then after that, after our discussion on measuring length using vernier calipers, we'll attempt some problems to be able to understand the whole topic at the end of the lesson. Now we want to begin by looking at choice of measuring instrument. How do you choose an instrument to measure a given quantity? So choice of measuring instrument. So what are some of the factors that will convince you, that will inform you to choose a given instrument for a given purpose? So this is what you have to note. In measurement, the instrument's use depends on this mesh size and the level of accuracy needed. So the kind of instrument that you choose to actually take a given measurement depends on the measurement you have to take, the size of the object that you're taking its measurement, and the accuracy that you need. So there are three factors here that you have to consider. First of all, you have to look at the measurement. Which measurement do you have to take? And then what's the size of the object that you're taking? You're taking the measurement, and what accuracy do you want? What accuracy do you expect to get at the end of the activity? So these are some of the things that have to be considered. Now, previously, we realized this. Although a meter rule and a tape measure are used to measure distance, both cannot be used directly in all situations. We know what a meter rule is. A meter rule can be used to measure distance. We can also use a tape measure to measure distance, but we cannot use these two instruments in all situations. There are situations that we cannot be able to apply these two. So they can be used selectively. In other areas, we may not be able to use these two apparatus that we're discussing here. And we have noted this example here that, for example, when measuring the circumference of a tree trunk, one would find it unsuitable to use a meter rule. So you want to take the circumference of a tree trunk. So it becomes, it's not possible for you to use a meter rule to measure the circumference of a tree trunk. How do you do it? Because in the first place, a meter rule is very rigid. It can't take the circumference of a tree trunk. So this example in itself actually confirms the last point that we have just discussed, that they cannot be used to measure distance in other situations. Like now, these situations here where you have to measure the circumference of a tree trunk, we can't use a meter rule. In such cases, a tape measure would be more suitable. So if you want to take the circumference of a tree trunk, you can't use a meter rule. Now, what do you use? You can use a tape measure. So a tape measure would be able to be, it's a bit flexible and now can be used to measure that circumference. So you realize that these apparatus or the instruments are used in different situations. So you cannot apply in all the situations. What about a case where you want to measure the volume of a regular solid such as a cuboid? Can be obtained by measuring the length, width, height, or by displacement method. So now in this case here, you want to calculate the volume of a regular solid. The word here is regular. Therefore, this solid has a definite shape. It's in the shape of a cuboid. Therefore, you can use the formula to measure length. You calculate the length, width, and then the height to work out the volume of this cuboid. You can also use the method of displacement to work out the method of this particular cuboid. But you cannot use it in all situations that requires to calculate what? Calculate the volume of some of the objects that you're going to measure. So it's therefore true to say that, however, to measure the volume of sand, soil, or solid chemical substance, the use of the above method would be inappropriate. That's very true. So you can't use the same method to measure the volume of sand, soil, or a solid chemical substance. For example, if you have sand, how do you use that formula to calculate the volume of a sand? The volume of sand, how do you use that? It's not possible, it's inappropriate. What about soil? Still the same, and some solid chemical which may not have regular shape. They are irregular. So we cannot employ this method in calculation of the volumes of sand, soil, or solid chemical. That's why we are saying how to choose a method depends on the situation in which you are now, the situation and the results you want to achieve at the end of that particular exercise. Now, as a result of this, we therefore want to look at some of the two instruments used to measure length or the dimensions of given objects accurately. The two accurately measuring instruments that we use in physics. Now, that's what we want to discuss. So we are looking at the two accurately measuring instruments, and the two accurately measuring instruments are, one, vernier calipers. The first one is a vernier calipers. We call it vernier calipers, and we are going to look to actually discuss why this instrument is called a vernier caliper, or they're called vernier calipers. That's the first instrument that is used to measure, to give accurate measurements. The other one is called micrometer screw gauge. Micrometer screw gauge. Now, micrometer, micro means something very small, something that is very small. So this one gives you some information that micrometer screw gauge is an instrument that is used to measure small dimensions or the size of very small objects. Micrometer, for example, what is the thickness of your hair? What is the thickness of your hair? Just pick one of your hair and then what's the thickness of that hair? Now, you know what now comes into your mind? You are not able to measure the thickness of your hair. And the reason is because it is too small that you cannot measure. So that one is called fact, because you are able to measure the length or the thickness of that hair. We have an instrument in the lab that can be used to measure that, and that's what we call micrometer screw gauge. Micro meaning small. So these are some of the two apparatus or equipment that can be used to measure accurately in the laboratory. So we want now to look at vernier calipers in details. So vernier calipers. So vernier calipers is one instrument that is used to measure accurately in the laboratory. So how did the vernier calipers come into existence? That's the first question that we have to ask ourselves. Who invented a vernier caliper? What's the origin of the name vernier calipers? These are some of the questions that we have to understand. So we have vernier and then we have calipers. Calipers is something like a holding device, a device that holds. But the other one, vernier, could be the name of a person. So let's try to find out how this instrument came into existence. And then we have this now. We have this individual here. Now, this individual that we see here is the inventor of vernier calipers. And this individual here was a technician So when you talk about a technician, this is someone who was working in a lab long time ago, and he was the one who invented the vernier caliper. He was actually a French technician, and his name was Pierre Vanier. So Pierre Vanier was the inventor of the vernier calipers long time ago in 1700 century. That's the time vernier calipers came into existence. Therefore, when you talk about vernier calipers, first of all, we have to give credit to the person who came up with this apparatus. So this is what we say about vernier calipers. Vernier calipers was invented in 17th century by a French technician called Pierre Vanier. This is the founder of the vernier caliper. So the one we use, that one in your school, yeah, that one was invented by the vernier caliper. When you go back to your school and you are having a discussion with your friend, one of the questions you should ask your friend, who is the inventor of a vernier caliper? Now that you have just learned this on Elim TV. So go ask your friend so that if they're able to tell you, then if they're not able to tell you, then tell them that the inventor is Pierre Vanier. We invented the vernier caliper. So that from the word vernier calipers, the first one, vernier, is the name of the inventor, and then the calipers is a holding device. Because as we're going to look at the structure of the vernier caliper, it has some jaws, and jaws are meant to hold. So calipers for holding, so that you can be able to measure. So this instrument was invented in 17th century, as I've just said, by this man called Pierre Vanier. Therefore, what can we say about this apparatus or instrument? So vernier calipers, so we have now, we have the diagram of this. This is now a clear diagram of the vernier caliper. So this is the one that we have here. This one is our vernier caliper. Now, the vernier calipers is used to measure short distances, such as the diameters of small ball, thin rod, internal diameters of tube, and other small distances. So this instrument here is used to measure small distances of diameters of small balls, thin rod, internal diameters of a tube, etc. So that's one area in which you are able to apply this vernier caliper. You realize that the meter rule and the tape measure can be used to measure the length, the size, or the long size distances and diameters in case of a tape measure. But now, in case where we have small, like a ball bearing, you cannot use a tape measure to measure the diameter or the circumference of a ball bearing. You require at least an instrument that will give you an accurate measure of that ball bearing. So we use vernier calipers because they can be able to measure those small or short distances. Now, a vernier caliper has two scales. It has two scales, and these scales are known as, we have the first one, the first scale is known as the main scale, and we have it here. So it has two scales, and the first scale we are discussing is the main scale. So we have in this diagram the main scale there. The arrow is pointing towards the vernier scale, but we have to discuss the main scale here. Now, what about this main scale of the vernier caliper? It consists of a steel rigid frame onto which a linear scale is engraved. So this scale is made up of a steel rigid frame onto which a linear scale is engraved. It has a scale that is engraved, and you're able to see here, like in this case, the scale that is engraved runs from 0 up to 10, or 0 up to 10. And therefore, because it runs from 0 up to 10, in which units are this? In which units is the scale engraved? Now, this is another thing that you have to say about this scale. The scale that is linear is what we call the main scale. So this scale is known as the main scale. So we are just repeating on the same, we're just saying that the main scale consists of a steel rigid frame onto which a linear scale is engraved, and therefore the scale itself is called the main scale. So still on the main scale of the vernier caliper, we can also say this. So we have a diagram of the vernier caliper, it is here. Now, so let's now do the diagnosis of the vernier caliper. This is what we have here. We have the inside jaws, we have the outside jaws. So you note that the outside jaws are used to measure the diameter, the external diameter of an object. So we have an object here, which may be a ball bearing. So we are taking it is a diameter. We use the outside jaws or external diameter jaws. We have the inside jaws. Then we have the vernier scale, and we also have the main scale that is engraved on a steel rod. So this is what you can say. The main scale is calibrated in centimeters and millimeters. So This main scale is calibrated in both centimeters and millimeters. So we can measure the length of any given object using a vernier caliper in either centimeters or millimeters. It has fixed and sliding jaws. So a vernier caliper has fixed and sliding jaws. The sliding jaws are on the vernier scale. The fixed jaws are on the main scale. So it has fixed and sliding jaws. Then we move on. We go to the vernier scale. We said there are two scales of the vernier caliper. We have the main scale and the vernier scale. So what about the vernier scale? So the vernier scale is what we have here. This is our vernier scale. Scale spacing 0.9. We have the main scale up there that is not seen. So we have the vernier scale here. So a vernier scale has a length of 9 millimeters in 10 pieces. That's one thing that we have to note. It has 9 millimeters in 10 pieces, meaning that one space on a vernier caliper has a length of 9 millimeters divided by 10, and this is going to give us 0.9 millimeters. This one will bring us to something that we're going to discuss later on in this lesson about the precision of a vernier caliper. Because on the main scale, we have 10 units. On the vernier scale, we have 9 millimeters of 10 pieces. So it is one piece less of the main scale. So if we have to look at the precision is in the order of 0.1 millimeters, which is the same as 0.01 centimeters. Some bit of mathematics there. Are we together? Now, let's move on. It has a length of 9 millimeters that are divided into 10 equal divisions. I've just explained that. And because of that, each division has a length of 0.9 millimeters. Now, how do you get 0.9 millimeters? You take 9 divided by 10 and you'll end up with 0.9 millimeters. Then, you know, on the main scale of the vernier caliper, it has 10 units. And those 10 units are in millimeters. It's the same as 10 millimeters. So those 10 millimeters are the same as 1 centimeter because you divide by 10. So if you take 10 millimeters minus 0.9 millimeters on the vernier scale, you have 0.1 millimeters. So 0.1 millimeters becomes the precision of the vernier caliper that we're just about to discuss. So that one directs us to this. So this is what we say, still on the vernier scale. The difference between one division on the main scale and one division on the vernier scale is 1 minus 0.9 millimeters. I've just explained that. It has a 1 unit less. The difference is 1 minus 0.9 millimeters. And therefore, this one is going to give us what? This one gives us a unit called the smallest or the least count. The least count. So the least count is LC. The least count is the least unit that you can be able to measure with a vernier caliper. So the smallest reading called the least count, LC in bracket, that can be read from a vernier caliper is 1 millimeters minus 0.9 millimeters. And this one is going to give us 0.1 millimeters, which is equivalent to 0.01 centimeters. Understood? So because on the vernier scale, it is 9 millimeters per 10 counts or units. And then on the main scale is 10 millimeters per 10 units. So meaning that when you take 10 divided by 10 on the main scale, you get 1 millimeters that we have here. Then on the vernier scale, when you take 9 millimeters divided by 10, you get 0.9 millimeters. So what's the difference between the two? Is 1 millimeters minus 0.9 millimeters, which is going to give us 0.1 millimeters, or 0.01 centimeters. That's how we get that one there. Is it clear? So this one gives us a view of what a vernier caliper is. We have just discussed what a vernier caliper is. We have looked at the skeleton of a vernier caliper and how it is used, which kind of measurements it can use to measure. Now, the difference between one division on the main scale and one division in the vernier scale is given by 1 minus 0.9 millimeters, and this gives us a quantity called the least count. The smallest reading called the least count that can be read from the vernier calipers is 1 millimeters minus 0.9 millimeters, which is going to give us 0.1 millimeters or 0.01 centimeters. And I hope this one is understood, because how do we get 1? 1 is from the main scale, is 10 millimeters for every 10 units. So 10 divided by 10, you end up with 1 millimeter. On the vernier scale, it's 9 millimeters for 10 units. So it's 9 divided by 10, you get 0.9. So when you take 1 millimeters on the main scale minus 0.9 millimeters on the vernier scale, you end up with 0.1 millimeters or 0.01 centimeters. Write somewhere that 0.1 millimeters or 0.01 centimeters is the precision of a vernier caliper. What do you mean by that? Oh, you are writing 0.1 millimeters or 0.01 centimeters is the precision of a vernier caliper. This means that the least unit that a vernier caliper can measure is 0.1 millimeters or 0.0 centimeters. Now, from the onset about the vernier caliper, this value can be able to tell you how small a vernier caliper, how small the dimension that a vernier caliper can be able to measure. 0.01 centimeters is a very small length that a vernier caliper measures, which cannot actually be measured by what? A meter rule. It can also not be measured by what? A tape measure. You do therefore agree that a vernier caliper is used to take the measurement of the small objects. It's definitely true. So that's how we use the vernier caliper. So now, in summary, we have just discussed about a vernier caliper and how it is used and how we can be able to read, do the readings, and how we can be able to use it in making or taking some measurements. So in our next lesson, what we are going to do, we are now going to look at how do you use a vernier caliper in measurement. So we shall employ the use of a vernier caliper in measurement. That's what we're going to do in, the, in our next lesson. However, for this lesson, you will have this assignment. Using a well-illustrated diagram, describe the various parts of a vernier caliper. Given that our discussion has all been about the skeleton of a vernier caliper, now your assignment is, using a well-illustrated diagram, describe the various parts of a vernier caliper. So this is what you're going to do. You draw the vernier caliper, you describe the various parts of the vernier caliper, so that this one will help you understand how we are able now to apply the use of a vernier caliper in measurement. So until then, you can contact us or send your questions and compliments, comments on this. You can SMS on the number 22518. You can also use our Facebook page, Elimu TV, and follow us on Twitter at Elimu_KE. Up to there, I've been your teacher, Benjamin K. Makanda. Until next time, stay tuned to Elimu TV.